Barb Clausen is watching.
So too. We brought clothes just in case.
Well, we're getting pretty good snow, but
it's supposed to be short-lived.
Yep. How's the retirement thing? You busier than you were before?
Pleasantly busy.
Doing the things you want to do now.
Doing the things I want to do. Sleeping as long as I want. Waking up when it's time to wake up, and not any sooner.
That's awesome. Hopefully never an alarm clock again.
Well, there's always times for that.
Okay.
morning.
It is good to be back with you today. Very good to be back with you. It's been quite a week throughout the country, hasn't it? So we want to keep in our prayers all those who have been snowed in, snowed under, without power and electricity and water and all that goes with it. There are many that are still in that condition, and I think we especially want to keep the homeless in our prayers. I just opened up my mail from the last week, and in it is this lovely little letter that says, "Good morning. I was at an antique store some time ago and found this 1950 picture card of your church." Isn't that cool? I thought you might enjoy it. The postage on here is 1 cent. 2 cents if it's foreign. It's from a Mr. Lowell Jorg from Stockton, California. So you just never know where you might find this. But you'll have to look at that. That's a neat, neat card. Does anyone have any announcements to share? No? Okay, then let us turn our hearts and minds to God. Please stand. As we begin this year's Lenten journey, the temperature moves back above freezing, our pipes are starting to thaw, and hope turns to spring, even if it is still snowing outside. Vaccines are here, and a pandemic is possibly coming under control. And yet, we still find ourselves with a need to be reminded of God's love for us. And so we come today to seek, to pray, to sing, and to worship in person and online. And I ask you now to please join me in our prayer. To you, Holy One, we lift our hearts.
misconstrue, misrepresent, and misapply your word. You speak of covenant. What we think of, especially during these months, is duty, obligation, expectation, rules and regulations, consequences by which we mean punishment. What you mean, what your intent has always and ever been, is relationship, connection, and collaboration. Because your story is, above all else, a love story. You seek with love, in love. You draw in, make way, instruct, offer mercy, redemption, restoration, and salvation. You call us beloved and ask us to regard and relate to one another the same way. Forgive us when we don't. Forgive us for the times we put words in your mouth, the instances when we refrain from voicing life and love and hope.
The steadfast love of the Lord is everlasting to everlasting. God's covenant, God's word, endures forever. And God's word is love, mercy, salvation. Believe the good news and be at peace. In Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
Thanks be to God.
Listen to the word of God in Genesis chapter 9, verses 8 to 17. God said to Noah and his sons with him, I am now setting up my covenant with you and your descendants, and with every living being with you, with the birds, with the large animals, and with all the animals of the earth. Leaving the ark with you, I will set up my covenant with you, so that never again will all life be cut off by floodwaters. There will never again be a flood to destroy the earth. God said, this is the symbol of the covenant that I am drawing up between me and you and every living thing with you. On behalf of every future generation, I have placed my bow in the clouds. It will be the symbol of the covenant between me and the earth. When I bring clouds over the earth and the bow appears in the clouds, I will remember the covenant between me and you and every living being among all the creatures. Flood waters will never again destroy all creatures. The bow will be in the clouds, and upon seeing it, I will remember the enduring covenant between God and every living being of all the earth's creatures. God said to Noah, this is the symbol of the covenant that I have set up between me and all creatures on earth. Psalm 25, verses 1 to 10. Lord, I give myself to you. My God, I trust you. Do not let me be disgraced. Do not let my enemies laugh at me. No one who trusts you will be disgraced, but those who sin without excuse will be disgraced. Lord, tell me your ways. Show me how to live. Guide me in your truth. Teach me, my God, my Savior. I trust you all day long. Lord, remember your mercy and love. You have shown them since long ago. Do not remember the sins and wrong things I did when I was young, but remember to love me always, because you are good, Lord. The Lord is good and right. He points sinners to the right way. He shows those who are not proud how to do right. He teaches them his ways. All the Lord's ways are loving and true for those who follow the commands of his agreement. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Safe.
much like the time that we have spent with our pots, our soil, and our seed, Lent is a time of reflection, a time of waiting. It is a time of studying the scriptures. It is a time of spending time in prayer. We look for ways in Lent to feed and nourish ourselves as we journey through this time. And it is that nourishment that helps to feed us, to feed our minds and our bodies and our souls. It helps to nurture us as we grow in our connection with God and with our church and with one another. God is this little plot. And God holds that which makes us and keeps it safe. Like the seeds in our pots, each of us will grow differently. No one's journey will be the same as another. And yet the one thing that's certain, the one sameness, is that God will surround us and keep us safe. The same could be said of Christ Church. Each member, each seed, each congregation grows differently. We can't compare ourselves to another congregation. However, we can do what is necessary to feed and nourish ourselves as we grow. And that doesn't necessarily mean numbers-wise, although that's always a nice benefit. But it could just mean that we grow in our purpose, our mission. Grow in our faith. And help others grow in theirs. Grow so that not only do our own lives bloom, but the lives of others. This Lenten season, let us work together to keep the seeds of faith, our faith, the seeds of our love, the seeds of our desire for justice for all of God's creation. Seeds that this congregation planted and was planted in, so that we will continue to grow in and beyond this particular season of our lives. Into the season of generations to come. God made us a perpetual promise. Let us make that same promise so that others can grow in their faith. Thank you. turn to you, Holy One, my deepest, truest self. I trust in you, Holy One. Shelter me from shame.
We trust in you, Holy One. Shelter us from shame.
I learn from you, Holy One. Teach me your way of love. I hope in you, Holy One, my liberation, justice, truth.
We hope in you, Holy One, our liberation, justice, truth.
Please remember, Holy One, your enduring mercy and loving kindness. Do not remember, Holy One, please, my turning from your way.
Remember us, Holy One, in the light of your mercy and love.
You are good, Holy One, good and generous and just. Teach the humble, Holy One, what is right and good and just.
Teach the humble, Holy One, lead us to walk your path.
Your paths alone, Holy One, are the paths of faithful loving kindness. All who follow Holy One's ways will find steadfast life-giving love.
Teach us to walk, Holy One, your way of justice, kindness, and love.
This we pray
as we join together praying. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
In Lent, we have
been
remember the gifts that God gave us to help nourish us during our journey. And our offering is one of the ways that we, as part of the body of Christ, can share in the nourishment with others. Your generosity in this very challenging time is needed, and it is appreciated as we seek to continue the mission and the ministry of the Congregational United Church of Christ. For those worshiping in person, there's an offering plate at the back of the sanctuary. If you cannot be with us physically, consider mailing your offerings to the church, 111 Taft Street North in Humboldt, or dropping them off in our mailbox, or arranging an electronic transfer from your financial institution. Please join me in our prayer.
In joyful response to your sustaining grace, God of all, we share our gifts that they may help plant seeds of hope in the lives of others. Amen. Butterflies will soon be
Oops. Sorry.